J-Man the Vandewall fan back at it again with another video. As always, I would like to welcome all of my fellow Vandewallers and any guests who are hopefully discovering grace for the first time. If that is the case, we are hopefully all in for a treat on this one because I'm going to try something different here. I have one rule. Hate, disrespect, and negativity. Stays at your fingertips and out of my comment section. I refuse to accept you saying anything negative about grace in my comment section. If I see it, I will erase it. If you have a problem with that, go to someone else's page. Plain and simple. Do not talk crap. Do not spit on her name. And do not be negative or an asshole on my channel about Grace Vandewall. If you want to talk about her, you be respectful. I don't care if you like her or not. It doesn't matter to me. You're not me. I'm not here for the people that don't like her. I'm here for the people that do, because I do. If you want to be negative on my page, I will take it off. And because YouTube gave me that right. That said, I have some other videos I need to work on, but this is a test video. And I'm gonna get all the, you all know who you are, who I've got videos coming for. I've just been really, really busy, and I didn't expect it to happen like that, and so I apologize. Now, that said, you already know what song we're doing. And I feel like the song gets no love anymore. Like, you go to the music video or the live, the one we're doing, which is Live at the Slipper Room. There's like no activity. And it's, what's this? I won't lie. When I first heard this song, I wasn't interested in it at all. It didn't catch me in the slightest. And I guess next time, I don't know, I got curious and I went and listened to it again, but this time I shut my mouth and I opened my ears, and this is literally, I won't say it's one of my favorite songs, because I can't do that anymore. But this is absolutely, oh, I don't know how to say it, but this is literally one of the best. I can't do that. I could say that about every single one of her songs. This is an absolutely wonderful song. It's beautiful, and it's, the way she wrote it is just, this girl is just unstoppable. But anyways, I'm fading the video, and I'm flipping it. I've seen people do that, and they've been able to get the videos past the a copyright claim. So let's hope so, because I want to start doing Don't Assume What You Don't Know, Repeat, So Much More Than This, all the music videos. I want to start getting them on here, and I can't do that until I can get past the copyright claims. So, that said, let's go ahead and get started on this. I hope you guys are as happy as I am about this, because I haven't listened to this song in so long. It's been so long, and I'm so excited to listen to it, because I love this song so much. I'll give you guys a little peek at it. If it gets through, let me know if it's too faded, and I'll do what I can. But it's going to be flipped. Remember, it's going to be flipped. Wish me luck.
I wanna write a song, one that can explain my lungs.
Real quick, this is try this sometime if you ever get up to it. Seriously, click on this, listen to 10 seconds of it. 10 seconds of it. Go to the music video, listen to 10 seconds of it. Tell me there's no difference, because there is no difference. None. Zero. Zilch. She sounds identical in this live recording as she does in the music video. Tell me that is not insane. Tell me that is not insane. Insane.
I wanna write a song that you can hear and know how my heart yearns and how my insides churn and how my cheeks burn from the weekly storm. My face turns before you return to the wall and then down the floor. But I keep only seeing rain. I will say no, but you keep crawling in my brain. I wanna get lost, run away. In the dark is where I'll stray.
Those of you that don't know for sure, this, now I'm not even 100% sure, and I would like to be educated on the issue. Did she write this on tour with Imagine Dragons, and it was the only one she didn't throw out, or did she write it after she threw out the songs on Imagine Dragon? Because she says it's about the song she threw out on Imagine Dragon, but I've also heard that she threw all the songs out she wrote on while on tour with Imagine Dragons, except for this one. So if you know which one, which side of the story, or if there's a middle ground that's like totally different, that's what the two I've heard. She wrote a bunch of songs, threw all of them and this one out. She wrote a bunch of songs and wrote this song about throwing out those songs. So tell me which one it is. If you know.
I gotta write a song, but I wanna feel my words, and I keep getting it all wrong.
She didn't get anything wrong, well.
Think it out, write it out, rip it out, start all of a
Oh
war, and I keep only seeing rain. I will say no, but you keep crawling in my brain. I wanna get lost, run away. In the dark is where I'll. Feel the way I used to. I wanna move the way I used to grow. But I keep only seeing rain. I keep saying no, but you find your way into my brain. I wanna get lost, run away. In the dark is where. Keep crawling in my brain. I wanna get lost, run away. In the dark is where I'll stray.
Oh gosh, I literally just got chills all over. Oh God. It has been a long time since I've heard this song, and I. God. Who is this girl? Who is she? Who is she? This is
I wanna feel the way I used to. I wanna move the way I used to grow. I wanna feel the way I used to. I wanna feel the way I used to.
Look at the look on her face right there when she finishes singing. Look at the look on her face. It's almost like she was a little scared.
Thank you.
I love that about her. I did that. Okay. I know she was nervous from what I understand. She was this was the first time she'd ever performed that song, and she was nervous. Who wouldn't be? I mean, she did. She it was different, and I know that a lot of people, a lot of her older fans, apparently said that she had sold out and that she the magic was gone. I don't know why they thought that, because what that song. That song is a whole new line of magic to me. I mean, literally, it's like this is the way I describe it. It's like Perfectly Imperfect and JTB were literally like the parlor tricks. Now, Stray is the beginning of the actual magic show to me. I mean, don't get me wrong, and I'm not saying I'm just using it as an example. I love the JTB and I love Perfectly Imperfect. I actually love them. I think they're fantastic. But Stray and Letters are, and then you don't assume what you don't know, and Repeat are literally just. How could you think that about her? How could you consider that selling out? What about that is selling out? She, She was maturing, she was growing up, she was writing different. She can't keep her 12 forever, people. It seems like that was part of the contract that she signed when she won AGT. You have to stay 12 forever. Well, guess what? It's just not gonna happen. And she's not gonna stay 13 forever, 14, 15, 16, 17. She's not even gonna stay 18 forever. So I was scared to watch the Don't Assume What You Don't Know. I was scared to watch it. I was when I started journeying down the rabbit hole. That's about the only thing I remember, because I don't remember any of it otherwise. I don't remember any of it. I don't remember any of it. I remember watching the AGT performances, and this big hole opened up on the end of the winning part of the video I saw. I jumped in, and I don't remember anything until I saw one of those videos. I think it was of Grace VanderWaal, I can't remember what it was called, but it was one of the ones where it was talking about, the truth. I think it was the truth about Grace VanderWaal, and it immediately struck me as the truth. What do you mean the truth? Like, what are they gonna tell me? Is he gonna tell me she's gonna be a monster? She's like got something, she's a cuckoo or something. I was like, no, don't tell me this is the truth. I was hesitant to watch that stuff because I was so scared that it was gonna lead me away from her, and I didn't want that to happen because I was enjoying the ride so much. I do remember that. I do remember that. I just don't remember where the songs were and the grouping of everything. But I remember seeing her with a shaved head, and through everything that was going on around that, it just kind of scared me a little bit because I was afraid to explore that part of her, because not because she shaved her head, but because of what I was seeing about it. And but finally I gave in, and not only did I watch the videos about the truth about Grace, man, which was everything that I already pretty much knew, I watched Don't Assume What You Don't Know, and let me tell you something, I thought the song was fantastic. I was so scared, not because of the shaved head, just because everything was going on around the shaved head. And I thought she pulled off the look fantastically. I mean, she could pull off any look, as far as I'm concerned. But I just realized how foolish I was and how silly I was being about the whole thing. I'm like, really? I mean, what? And I now that I'm that once I got past Don't Assume What You Don't Know, it was easy breezy from there. I didn't buy any of the crap that I saw or heard people see people post or anything. That's probably the time I entered my official first phase of becoming an actual Fanderwaller, if you will, Fanderwall. That moment, because I felt like, okay, this is all these people are just blowing smoke up my ass, and I don't want that anymore. And then when I crossed the line and jumped into the Don't Assume What You Don't Know, I literally was just gone. I was like, okay, this girl, she just keeps getting better. She just keeps getting better. Letters is literally my favorite collection of songs ever written, period. But Don't Assume What You Don't Know is just that much better, and Repeat is that much better to me. I mean, I just. And then I saw this. I see. I was hesitant to, at first when I first saw her seeing them, to see the Just Kids and everything, because I'm not big on those kind of recording releases. I don't like that kind of stuff, but it sounded good to me. I mean, it sounded decent enough that I was like, oh my God, this is Just Kids was the first one. I was like, holy crap. And then I was like, okay, well, I'm gonna go listen to the others. And I listened to the others, and Need Me Now is okay at first, and I was like, that was a good song. And then I listened to it again, and I listened to it again, and then Just Kids was my favorite, and then Just Kids got bumped out by Need Me Now, and now Need Me Now is literally my favorite song. But my point of all this is literally saying that this girl is unreal. It's like I had those fears because they were implanted into me because of what other people were saying. That's probably what led me into the comment section to start fighting off all these idiots that say these mean things and these horrible things. It's because I was like, this isn't true. This is the girl that I'm seeing, the girl that I'm watching grow up, in the short amount of time that I did. I literally watched several Facebook lives and Instagram lives and stuff like that, live streams, and I literally watched her grow up in a very short amount of time, and I wasn't seeing any of these things, and I was just like, what is going on here? And when I started diving into the comments, I started seeing all the same stuff, and I'm like, man, this is gonna scare someone else off. This is gonna scare a potential fan off because it almost did me, or it almost it, I thought it would. I don't want people to have false information. That's another reason why I don't want negativity on my page about Grace VanderWaals, because I don't want to scare future fans off, because she deserves every fan she can get, and so many people get so scared easily about stuff like that, and I don't want that. I want her to have fans. I want her. I want people need to know who she is. They need to know. They just need to know she is. This girl's not real. This is almost like virtually impossible that she could exist. I don't know. But you got lucky. We don't deserve her. We do not. You know we do not deserve her. I don't think I have to even say it, but I did. We don't deserve her. We don't. But we got her. She's the miracle. She's the miracle. It was no miracle she won. It's no miracle she won. She is the miracle. So this girl's just unreal. It's ridiculous. I don't know what to... I just look respect to all you veteran Vanderwallers for going through the waiting process like you did, because this is hell. This is pure hell waiting on the next drop, because I've seen everything. I mean, obviously there's still stuff that's getting thrown my way, then I'm like, okay, yes, I get to see something new. But I'm waiting for that new next drop. I'm waiting for it and waiting for it. I don't know how you did it and didn't have a heart attack. I don't know how you guys did it. I don't know. But props, because you guys are strong. You guys are super strong. I am running on wits end waiting for this next drop, and I'm sure you all too. You all are too. I can't talk today. But you're used to it. You've been through the waiting process. This is my first time. And it's hell. Maybe it is still hell for you guys. Maybe you guys all just like go crazy too. But I've never gone crazy waiting for someone to drop new music. Ever. Not ever. It didn't matter to me that much. Just when it came, it came. I still had plenty of other music to listen to. So, anyways. Let me know if I dimmed it too much, if it makes it onto the screen and onto YouTube, and I don't know what I've gotten myself into with this, but at least it's worth it. At least it's worth it. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll catch you on the next video.